A warm welcome to everyone. Today we are going to do the topic of accounting for merger. The topics covered are what is merger, amalgamation, what is the advantages and disadvantages of amalgamation, types of amalgamation and methods of amalgamation. Now, what is merger? Merger accounting is a technique used in preparing consolidated accounts and is therefore most easily understood and applied in accounting for group reconstructions, which involves the transfer of whole companies and where the consideration is in shares. So basically, what is merger? When A company and B company combine to form C company, it is called merger. Now, what is amalgamation? Amalgamation is occurred when two or more existing companies go into liquidation and a new company is formed to take over their business. It is known as amalgamation. The Institute of Chartered Accountants of India has issued Accounting Standard 14, that is AS 14, on accounting for amalgamation. This standard specifies the procedure of accounting for amalgamation and the treatment of any resultant goodwill or reserve. So I can give one example that company A is amalgamating company and company B is also amalgamating company. That is, A and B both are amalgamating company and new company, that is A and B company, is formed when the both of the company goes into the liquidation and new company is formed. Now, there are three terms that are used, that is amalgamation, absorption, external reconstruction. Now, what is amalgamation? Existing company A Limited and B Limited are wound up and a new company C Limited is formed to take over the businesses of A and B. That is, you have to form a new company C Limited that will take over the businesses of existing companies, that is A and B. Absorption. An existing company A Limited take over the business of B Limited, which is wound up. Then, external reconstruction. In external reconstruction, a new company X Limited is formed to take over the business of existing Y Limited, which is wound up. That is, taking over some other, when an existing company take over the business of another company, that is called external reconstruction. Now, many of the times students get confused what is the difference between amalgamation and merger. Merger and amalgamation are procedures that are undertaken in business circle by two or more company with a view to increase profit and to gain access to wider markets. In case of merger, what happens that two or more smaller companies lose their identities as they fuse into large company. That is, they are being merged into a large, small companies are merged into a larger company. But in amalgamation, all the combining companies lose their identities and a new independent company is formed. That is, in merger we can say that small companies are get dissolved into a bigger company, but in amalgamation a new company is formed. Now, what are the advantages and disadvantages of amalgamation? Firstly, it is easy in distribution. Then competition is over. There is more control on the business. More production will be possible. More capital formation will be there. On other hand, it has some disadvantages also. It increase in prices because you become the monopoly of the market. That is why you can charge the price you want. Then you can control the supply. The company controls the supply as well. If you control the supply, then you know that there is law of demand, we have studied that more is the demand, more is the price. and if the supply is less, the price will rise up. So there were chances of again overcapitalization, then harmful for small traders, and because big company will come into the market, they will charge the price whatever they want, and it is disadvantage for large production as well. Now there are two types of amalgamation. First is the amalgamation in nature of merger, and second is amalgamation in nature of purchase. That is, you merge a company, and then you other type of amalgamation is you purchase a company. Now what is amalgamation in nature of merger? In amalgamation should be considered in nature of merger, the following condition must be fulfilled. Firstly, the all the assets of the transferor company becomes the asset and liability of transferee company. Transferor company who is going to be get liquidated into the another company, that is a transferee company. So all the asset and liability becomes the asset and liability of the transferee company. Secondly, the shareholding not less than 90% of the face value of equity share capital of transfer company other than the equity share already held within immediately before the amalgamation by the transferee company or its subsidiaries become the equity shareholder of the transferee company by virtue of amalgamation. That is, the shareholder becomes the shareholders of the transferee company by the virtue of amalgamation. Thirdly, the business of the transfer company is intended to be carried on after the amalgamation by the transferee company. That is, the nature on the nature of the business remains the same. That is, the business which is being run by, which was being run by transferor company, becomes the business of the transferee company. Then amalgamation in nature of purchase. In amalgamation, in this type of amalgamation which does not satisfy any one or more of the conditions specified for amalgamation, it is the nature of merger. That is, the condition which I mentioned in amalgamation nature of merger, if any of the condition is not fulfilled, it becomes the amalgamation in nature of purchase. Now, what is the difference between amalgamation in nature of merger and amalgamation in nature of purchase? In this type of case, that is in merger, nature of merger, in this case, transferee company must acquire whole business of the transferor company, which includes all the assets and liability. We have already studied that the all the assets and liability of the transferor company becomes the assets and liability of the transferee company. But in nature of purchase, transferee company may or may not acquire all the assets and liabilities of the transferor company. So it transferee company, it's the will upon the of the transferee company whether to have the assets and liability of the transfer company or not. Second, shareholders having 90% of the face value of equity shares of the transfer company becomes the equity shareholder of the transferee company. We have studied this condition also, that 90% of the face value of equity shareholder of transfer company becomes the shareholder of the transferee company. But this condition is not applicable in case of amalgamation in nature of purchase. Third difference is the claim of the equity shareholder of the transfer company must be discharged by the transferee company by issuing equity shares only, except in the case of fractional shares. That is, it is the duty of the transferee company to settle down the claims of the equity shareholders of the transferor company. But in case of nature of purchase, the claim of equity shareholder of transferor company may be discharged by issuing equity shares or cash. So the claim of the equity shares of the transfer company may be discharged, that is again on the will of the transferee company. Now, we have studied the types of amalgamation, that is amalgamation in nature of purchase and amalgamation in nature of merger. Now there are two methods of for accounting for amalgamation, that is pooling interest method and second is purchase consideration method. That is when you acquire somebody's business, you have to give some amount of remuneration or purchase consideration in return. So there are two methods. One is the pooling interest method, other is purchase consideration method. In pooling interest method, asset, liability and reserves of the transfer company recorded at the existing carrying amount in the same form as the date of amalgamation, that is at the book value in which it was recorded in transfer company, the same value will be carried forward. The balance of profit and loss account of transfer company will be recorded at aggregate with corresponding balance of transferee company transferred to general reserve. That is, if any balance in profit and loss account of transfer company is there, we will aggregate that with the corresponding balance of transferee company and transfer it to general reserve. In pooling interest method, the difference between the amount recorded as share capital issued plus any additional consideration form of cash or any other form and the share capital of the transfer company is adjusted in reserves in the financial statements of transferee company. That is, share capital issued plus any additional consideration in form of cash or any other form minus the share capital of the transferer company is equal to adjusted in reserves of transferee company. That is what we have to do with the share capital. The share capital issued, that is whatever share capital is being issued minus the share capital of the transferer company is adjusted in the reserves of the transferee company. In purchase method, asset and liability of the transferer company is firstly incorporated at their existing amount. There are two ways to deal with this. Either you incorporate at the existing amount. Secondly, consideration allocated to individual identity assets and liability on the basis of their fair value at the date of amalgamation, that is market value or book value, whichever is higher, is considered for allocation in the amalgamation. Then the profit and loss balance of the transfer company, whether it is debit or credit, loses its identity. In purchase method, reserves of the transferer company, again there are two treatments, either the reserves other than statutory reserve are there, then it is not included in the financial statement of the transferee company. Second treatment is that if it is a statutory reserve, then it is to be included in the financial statements of the transferee company. Thank you very much. Hope you are able to understand the concept of amalgamation and different terms like amalgamation, what is external reconstruction, what is absorption, and hope you have able to understand the nature of amalgamation, that is nature of merger and nature of purchase. And we have studied the methods of doing amalgamation. So there are two methods. One is the pooling interest method. And that we have studied up the conditions, how to do the accounting for amalgamation. Hope you are able to understand the concept of accounting for amalgamation. Thank you very much.